Hi, I'm Paul Hoxers from Canon USA, and today we're excited to announce a suite of firmware updates to cameras in our Cinema EOS, Pro Camcorder, and 4K PTC product lines. Whether you already own one of these cameras or have been considering a purchase, these enhancements will add functionality and value for your production needs. Starting off with our top-of-the-line Cinema EOS series, the update includes a digital teleconverter for the EOS C500 Mark II, C300 Mark III, and C70 cameras. This function was already available on the EOS R5C camera, and now all four cameras in the series have up to an additional 3x digital zoom. The C300 Mark III, C500 Mark II, and C70 cameras will also be gaining compatibility with Canon's newly announced RCIP1000 controller. This compatibility enables a single operator to control up to 200 compatible Canon cameras from a single device, including camera monitoring and shading, helping to make multi-camera shoots a breeze. All four cameras are gaining flexibility with file naming conventions on proxy files, which enhances compatibility with nonlinear editing systems. Enhancements to the vector scope will now enable display of the vector color and color space on screen for your convenience. Additionally, the cameras will now be compatible with Canon's Super 35mm Flex Zoom lenses. For the native RF mount C70 and R5C cameras, the firmware will enable compatibility with newly announced RF lenses, including the RF 24-105 f2.8 lens and its optional power zoom adapter, as well as the RF Prime series of cinema lenses. The hybrid R5C is also gaining improvements to its photo mode, further cementing its status as a double-duty powerhouse. Moving on to the professional camcorders, the XF605 has already staked its claim as an elite tool for video production, and with this suite of upgrades, it's only getting stronger. Support has been added for the SRT protocol, which helps with live streaming over the web. Files can now be recorded in XFAVC, Full HD 25 megabits per second, and when recording in this mode, your proxy files can be recorded in MP4 at 16 megabits per second. Other additions include chunk recording and continuous playback of multiple clips. The XF605 is also gaining the same proxy file name versatility, RCIP1000 support, and vectorscope changes that are being added to the Cinema EOS cameras, plus several more functions that you can learn about on our website. Since being introduced, Canon's line of 4K PTC cameras have been a huge hit for productions of all sizes, and now we're helping to make them even better. The CRN700, CRN500, CRN300, and CRX300 cameras are gaining the ability to add a thumbnail image when utilizing the preset and trace functions. The thumbnail image can now be seen on the camera's user interface and while using the remote camera control application, which makes it easier for operators and directors to instantly be able to see which shot they want to call up next. We're also improving our SRT protocol functionality to support adaptive bit rate, and the 3D protocol will now support multiple destinations for metadata. The RCIP100 controller is also receiving a firmware update, which includes control of the auto tracking and auto loop paid applications, and the ability to register preset and trace thumbnails. Last but not least, Canon is introducing a new iPhone app that will allow for control up to four cameras from a single device. The C500 Mark II, C300 Mark III, C70, and XF605 cameras will be compatible with the Canon Multi-camera Control app, which provides the ability to control multiple cameras from a compatible iPhone device via Wi-Fi. The free app empowers you to have control over recording start and stop, focus, zoom and iris, ND filters, ISO, shutter, white balance, and custom picture control while viewing the image. These free firmware updates, including the new multi-camera control app, are currently scheduled to be available in early December. To learn more about the updates or the app, please visit our website,